Hello and welcome to the stream. Happy Monday. My plan for tonight is to draw some tomatoes because I'm tired and I just want to do something. I don't know. It's just what we're doing today. I really need to figure out another day to do this. Just because I tend to be tired in the evenings, and then I feel like I'm not particularly entertaining. Not that you need me to be super goof every day, but it would be nice if I wasn't tired and derping for the entire stream, so. So yeah, today is just going to be some quiet drawing time. I decided on tomatoes because I have them, and that's what I have. Good description, as per usual. So colored pencil is something I used to use a lot. I did quite a few commission drawings using Prismacolor colored pencils, and I don't use them as much as I used to, but I would like to. So, hence the pencils. I did think about painting tonight, but I was like, really feel like dealing with that mess tonight, so we're just gonna do this. Let's see, my sharpener. Thank you. So, not that anyone asked, but I like to use the larger hole for sharpening my colored pencils because it makes the angle a little bit like steeper. Like if I do this, it makes it really shallow and long, and I tend to break pencil tips a lot more and then waste pencil. So that's why I usually use the wider one, and then I don't sharpen it all the way. I just kind of get generally a point there, and then as you're drawing, you can kind of rotate it in your hand as you draw, and it sharpens it. I feel like when I know I'm being watched, which is every time I'm on stream, I forget how to use my hands. Making such a mess right now because I'm like, how do I hold my hands so that way A, you can see, and B, so I don't look stupid? But whatever, here we are. Only I would make sharpening pencils awkward. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it, but I've been where the hell is the thing? Collecting my pencil shavings in there. I don't know if I'll do anything with it, but it's a good spot to collect it for now. Oh, look at that. Made a nice mess of my shit. Okay. Then I smudge it. Okay. So in art class in high school, whenever I would get like the piece of paper that was on the floor that someone stepped on, I'd be like, well, my picture's already started for me, so we're just gonna go with that. I'm not gonna worry about it. So the first thing I'm gonna do is clean my tomatoes. So I really like this one. Oops, sorry. Just because of the kind of like red and dark, you can especially see it on this side if there wasn't a glare. I like the coloring on this one. I like the shape of this one, and then the yellow on this is really nice. So I don't know. I'm just gonna swatch these pencils and see what's what. Let's see. I think I'm gonna start with I'll just focus on this tomato for now. And we'll kind of focus on this side because it's mostly one color. There's some like veininess on this side and a little bit on this side, but I might just ignore that and just pretend like it's a solid color just for simplicity's sake. So, I'm gonna try Okay. Let's try. Let's see it. I think I like this pumpkin orange. It's kind of like this tomato isn't a very bright red, so I think that's gonna be my best bet. Throw in a little poppy red. this thing that I'm using is just, it's called a colorless blender, and I think it's basically, so the Prismacolor pencils are kind of made with waxy sort of pencil lead, and I think this is just kind of that wax but without any color in it, so you can just go in and blend your colors without adding more color. So that's what I'm doing now. That's good enough. As I keep touching it. Good enough. Keeps drawing. I mean, I could, you know, keep tickling it forever, but at some point you just have to be like, yep, that's good. Plus, we're not making a masterpiece here. Obviously, it's on, like, super thin paper. But, yay, tomato number one. How am I doing on time? I was gonna do a short stream today, so I might only have time for something very brief. So, let's do the yellow tomato if we can. Speed run this tomato. We're not gonna make it look accurate. We're just gonna speed run it. Hate it when I forget to clean off the, like, the whites or the colorless blender, the smudge stick. So I have all the crud on it from the red tomato. Knock it around. Let's see what color. I don't know if this, I didn't swatch at all, so this is gonna be a nightmare. She is not gonna look good. Yeah, I don't like that color at all. I feel like I need greens more than I need yellows. Purple. This is a little bit bright of a purple. How do I not have like a lavender purple? What is this? Clay rose. Oh, there's lavender. Okay. So we'll use that, I think, in a minute. This does not look good. oh well. We tried. It doesn't really have a whole lot of contrast in it. I don't know, maybe if I just add in the background, it'll stand out a little bit more. Let's try that. Let's see. I feel like it helped it a little bit. It still looks pretty flat for, like, in comparison to the other one. Let's see if we can help it out a little. Tomatoes. Happy Monday. That's all I got. See you guys Wednesday.